Hi everybody, hope you're doing well. Thanks very much for joining me this morning. Today we are taking a look at this built model of the Ferguson TE-20 tractor, or Little Grey Fergie, in 1/24th scale by a French kit manufacturer, Heller. Now, I was really, really pleased to get my hands on this. It's been available for a while, and I finally picked one up at a reasonable price online. And I'm very pleased I did, because it builds up very nicely indeed. And also, it really is, or the real tractor really is, a part of my childhood. When I was a little kid growing up in the east of England, these little tractors were absolutely everywhere, most of them still in use as well. And I think a number of them survive to this day, probably more as sort of cared for members of the family now rather than hardworking tractors, but still. So let's take a look at this one. I haven't got an unboxing for this one. There are numerous other really good unboxing videos on YouTube if you want to take a look though. So this is, as I say, 1/24th scale, and it's what I would call a really well thought out kit. Lots of thought has been put into it. So you might not look at this tractor and think that there would be many options. You know, there's not going to be an optional sunroof or optional sports wheels or anything, right? But there are some nice options included. Although they're sort of modest options, it's really nice that Heller went to the trouble to include them. So I'll talk a bit more about those as we get looking around the tractor. So first of all, what do you get? Well, I mean, it's basic. Everything's exposed there. You can see the little four-cylinder engine there, and the you can see the inlet manifold, exhaust manifold, the vertical exhaust. That's an option. So you have the option to build the vertical exhaust, which I've done on this one. There are separate parts to make a horizontal exhaust running under the bottom of the tractor, which I believe in real life would be used for tractors that were involved in work in orchards, for example, possibly some groundskeeping work. I'm not sure about that, but that certainly was an option on tractors of that era, I seem to have noticed. The tyres. Really, really nice big rubber tires on the back there with the correct pattern, and on the front as well, really skinny little rib tires. Again, that's an option. So we have, I've fitted the ones with three ribs. An alternative pair of front tires is provided with just a single rib as well. I just like the look of these ones better. Moving on around the front, that little grill, a hole in the bottom for a starting handle, Ferguson badge on there, two options provided there, a black one and a blue one. I don't know what the distinction is between those, to be quite honest with you. I chose the black one. Really great detail there. The only detail added to the engine is the wires from the distributor that you can see going to the spark plugs. Apart from that, that's just kit detail. You can just see the radiator and fan on the behind the grill there. Little toolbox on the side. Moving on to the cockpit, and what have we got? Well, we've got a very basic utilitarian looking metal seat. We've got a simple steering wheel, again, an optional part in the kit. There is a different, I believe, earlier style of steering wheel. And then our controls and gauges, which are on the basic side, to say the least there. Throttle on the steering column. Gear lever mounted between the driver's knees down there on top of the transmission. A number of other controls as well. So you've got left and right brake pedals there to independently brake each rear wheel to assist you when turning on rough ground or on a muddy field. Clutch pedal there as well, clutch pedals. And then moving on further back, the hydraulic lifting arrangement there and power takeoff, which I understand were real Ferguson innovations in that time period and really moved on the game as far as small farmers and smallholders were concerned. They could get a Ferguson TE-20 and suddenly have that kind of ability in the field to hydraulically lift a plough or any other piece of machinery that they were using there, have power takeoff as well, which means that they could use different kinds of machines. Apparently back in the day, that really was a step forward from Ferguson. So you'll notice the colour choice for this kit was relatively simple. I didn't spend hours agonising over what colour to do it. It's going to be grey. It's a little grey Fergie. The colour that I used in this case was, I think, a Ford colour. I would need to check on that, but I believe that's actually a Ford shade of grey that I used. for the entire thing, and all the practically all the kit parts are sprayed that color. The only parts that aren't are the steering wheel. I think there were one or two pieces on the engine, of course, coolant hoses and things, which are black. Otherwise, just about the entire thing done that color, as it was on the real tractor. Quite simple from that point of view, really. Actually quite strange to have so little painting to do other than just spraying everything the same shade. So that's what comes in the box. Very, very nice kit. I chose to represent a well-used example, just as I remember them as they were parked in field gateways and farmyards when I was a little kid. So a bit of rusting I've attempted to recreate there, particularly on the pressed metal panels, such as the bonnet and grille and the rear mudguards, and on the wheels as well. They always seem to catch a lot of the corrosion. I put a lot less rust on the other pieces, such as, for example, the engine and transmission, which is a large casing. Those sorts of things, I think, tend to rust a lot less than the thinner pressed metal that you get, which makes which is used to make mudguards and bonnet and so on. And the exhaust, of course, that came in for a bit of particular attention. Wanted that to look nice and rusted, because I always seem to go quickly. And a little bit of soot around the end there as well. There we go. These are still available. I'm not sure if they're still in production, but they seem to be available quite easily online. Even if you've not really any interest in tractors, I really recommend this kit. It's so, so nice to build. It's surprisingly fragile as well when it's done. It's such a delicate little thing, and the detail really is lovely. And you can have so much fun with it. You can make it look factory fresh. You can make it look old and worn. You can make it look derelict. You can muddy it up as if it's just come off the field. All sorts of things you could do and really have fun with it. I thoroughly recommend it. Hope you enjoyed that. Thank you very much for watching.